Well, IoT adoption there in the B2B world is a huge potential. What we see that it affects all our markets. The way that we are going to connect the digital and the real world, this is all about IoT, is something what allows you to drive the productivity to the next higher level, to shorten the time to market, which is an absolutely important KPI for many, or to increase the availability, the uptime of our technology, like for trains, which we want to optimize in really having an IoT maintenance, which allows us to really deliver 100% capacity rather than having a 99% or so availability. And it's a huge potential, and it cuts across all our markets which we are serving. I give you a reflection on talks to my customers. So first and foremost, customers are coming saying, I have a legacy world, I have a manufacturing running. How do I connect my devices? How do I get the data? So connectivity is number one. Followed by how to make it cyber secure, because they don't want to get the data to somebody else. And very often we are operating in a real-time environment in critical infrastructure, so cybersecurity is of essence. So we have to solve that first. And the next step comes, which is really figuring out what is the real value which we can drive with IoT? What are the new business models? How we can improve the overall value chain in a certain application? So business models and finding out the right pain points and solving them, that's the next challenge. In the transport sector, IoT will play an important role because the transport sector will see a fourth dimensional disruption. It's going to be autonomous, connected, electric and shared. So how disruptive can it be? The biggest point is, I do believe, is that IoT can tear down the silos between different modes. The real solution for cities, for example, is an intermodal, seamlessly integrated transportation, end-to-end transportation, where you use the different modes to the best. We do not believe that scooters or any kind of Uber alone does the trick, the combination makes it. And this is exactly where IoT can play its strengths, because you're aggregating the data, you're creating platforms, and really connecting all these different modes for the purpose of having a better, smoother, and eventually also less CO2 footprint transportation. So indeed, Siemens is working for more than 30 years on AI. I mean, the algorithms were there, but now the processing power is available. I think what's happening now is, number one, we have a huge processing power. We have all the data stored, and AI is really only getting traction if you have the data available where you can train your systems. So we believe the time is right. We can really see now that the traction is going on. If you ask me, am I happy with the adoption rate of new technologies? I would say no, it can go faster. And the reason is, in very instances, it's about the fear concerning cybersecurity, but it's also about the availability of the right capabilities and resources in the suppliers and our customers, so that you really have a chance to adapt your technology. In order to start this transformation, my advice would be, start first with identifying your biggest pain points. You can do that also with partners, or IoT Unit, for example. They would advise also and make co-creation workshops to find out where these are. Choose a partner to identify them, and then make a plan how you can dedicate it for this particular pain point, find a solution, and implement. So that means start narrow, make your first step, and grow from there. Because once you're sitting on a platform, on an IoT platform, then you can add more and more applications and drive it from there. So it's not a miracle, but you have to start. This is a big question about how does intelligent machines replace people in the work. I don't have a fear. Number one is, we are not going to replace people by machines, we're replacing eventually part of the work that humans can do by machines, firstly. Secondly, we're living in a world where the population is aging, so we have less and less labor in the market. In order to compensate while still growing, we need productivity, we need these machines which can take part of the work. And thirdly, human beings, they still have something which is very specific. And think about it, you don't have to show to your child 100,000 pictures of a dog before it will recognize a dog. So we do something magic.